Why don't names come to you when you want them to? And welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm actually going to be sitting down and answering all of your questions. And I think our last Q&A was sometime in December, and it's been a while since I actually sat down and spoke to you guys and answered your questions. So without further ado, let's straight jump in. The first question is by Kunal Sharma. He asked me, when will I visit Indore again? I visited Indore sometime last year, I think in February, and it was a trip with three of my other foodie friends, and our agenda was simple: just go there and explore Indore for food. If you guys haven't seen those Indore videos, I'm gonna link them somewhere in the description box, so make sure you check them. Right now I don't have any plans for visiting Indore, but I really hope I get to visit the place again, because it is such a food heaven. It's almost like it's dedicated to vegetarian street food, so I just really hope I get to visit Indore soon. The next question is by Poonam Mamnia, and she wants to know about my Instagram page and how did I start it, and how do I have so many followers, and how do I edit my Instagram videos. So there's a lot of questions in this one question, Poonam. So firstly, how did I start my Instagram page? I think I just started my Instagram page to share what I'm eating, and I used to be really horrible at photographs then. I still am pretty horrible at photographs, but once in a way I do manage a half decent click. So I think that is pretty much my Instagram story. And how do I have so many followers? I don't have that many followers. I just hit 10,000 followers like abhi, after I think over a year of doing Instagram. And I think getting more followers on Instagram is a function of actually putting out good content out there. Now, good content on Instagram doesn't mean that you have to put like the most perfect looking pictures. The content has to be relatable, because the audience who's seeing it, the people who are seeing those pictures, are just regular people, and they just want to be able to see a good picture and feel hungry from it if it's a food page. And she also asked me, how do I edit my Instagram videos? Now, I edit all of my videos, whether they're Instagram or YouTube, on iMovie. Next question, Mr. Pawan asked me, am I single? No, I'm not. Ishika Garg asked me, who is my favorite actor, actress? They keep changing, you know. If there's one person who I want to meet from Bollywood at the moment, it is Ranveer Singh. Shah Rukh Khan I like. I like Jennifer Aniston. I like Kareena Kapoor. Yeah, I think that's that. Arpita Goon asked me, why did you start making food vlogs and how has the experience been ever since? I started making food videos when I realized that I like capturing food on video. So initially my vlogs were more of a visual thing, like I wasn't narrating anything. I was just like food getting made, or you know, a pizza getting assembled, things like that. And it's only later that I added a narration to it when I felt that there are people who want to listen. And yeah, so that's how I started making, and my experience has been really good. It's a very creatively enriching experience. I absolutely love it. Majorist Gamers asks me, when did I start making videos? I think I started making videos on YouTube at least 2 to 3 years ago. I had another channel dedicated to beauty as well, and that was actually started much before this one. He also asked me, what is your favorite South Indian food? Idlis. I mean, you know that there was this one meme, and it was like just me. Like, that meme just encapsulates my whole life. I don't know who else would go around tasting different types of idlis and actually making a video about it. He also asked me, why no videos on visiting South India and having authentic South Indian food? By the way, authentic South Indian food are really nice. It is different from what you get in Mumbai. So no videos on visiting South India, because I haven't really visited too much of South India yet. It is on my list. I hope I can plan it sometime soon. But yeah, till then, I'm just visiting the most authentic South Indian food which is available to me in Mumbai. Okay, Rajkumar Modi asked me, are you single and what is your favorite dish? No, I'm not single. And my favorite dish ever would be... And my favorite dish is actually a constant clash between pav bhaji and idli. So yeah. Nishchay Srivastav asked me, which food you like most, street food or restaurant food? Street food, hands down. Parikshit Arya asked me, tell us about your professional life and how you became a YouTuber. So I was in the mobile marketing space for about 8 years, and I decided to quit my job one day and start blogging. And one thing led to another, and I started doing YouTube, and that's really it. Krisha Savla asks me, who is your favorite beauty blogger? My favorite beauty blogger is Kaushal Beauty, and I also like the Anna Edit. Keval Kulkarni asked me what is my real profession. My real profession is making videos on YouTube. Urvi asked me, how do you manage your funds for food blogging? I get this question a lot. Now, mostly I fund my own videos, but it happens a lot that restaurants actually invite me over to experience their food and chat with my audience and social media about it. What's your all-time favorite dish and which is at one restaurant in Mumbai that you would like to visit often? This is asked by Mohammad Raza Alwani. My all-time favorite dish would be, as I said earlier, it's always a tie between pav bhaji and idli. And the one restaurant that I like to visit in Mumbai very often, actually there are quite a few. I love Swati Snacks. I think that's the restaurant that I visit very often. Another restaurant that I like is Shri Thakur Bhojanalaya, where you get the best thali in Mumbai. It is hands down the best Gujarati thali, not just in Mumbai, ever. Like, that's another place that I visit quite often. Avery or Avery, I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing this wrong, ask me, is your channel name inspired by the Powerpuff Girls, Sugar Spice and Everything Nice? No, but the amount of times I get asked this, I should just say yes. Monica Chhabria asked me, are you married? Yes. Ritvik Thakkar asked me, do you have any interesting story or experience while filming? Yes, the one thing that happens to me while filming every single time is that I am there talking to myself on my camera or on my phone and people around are just like, what is she up to? Like, why is she doing this? And they're just like staring at me and, you know, wondering what is wrong with me. So that happens all the time, especially when you're filming street food. It is like, sometimes I just feel it's like inviting, you know, all of those weird stares, but that's what I do and that's what I like doing, so I do it. Tasi Khan. I'm sorry, Tasi, if I'm pronouncing it wrong. Are you married? Yes, I'm married. The next question is from Priyanka Dodeja. She asked me, which is the best place for desserts in Mumbai, precisely chocolate desserts. I would say Theobroma. Theobroma is really, 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 really good for their brownies. Mostly you'll find a good variety of eggless and ones with egg. But my most favorite dessert over there is the After 9 pastry. I absolutely love chocolate and mint as a combination. And that's the one place in Mumbai which does it brilliantly. If you like chocolate and mint, then try it. Ekta Mehtani asked me, as you have visited both the places, Nail Spa Experience and A Creations, which place you think is better for getting nails done? I think A Creations had done a much better job with my nails. So those were all the questions that I had for today. It was actually quite fun filming this video, and if you would like me to do more chatty videos or more live sessions, then make sure you leave that in the comments below and we can set that up. And that is it from me, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!